I'm joined again by Dr. Rick Bright. He's an immunologist, virologist, and serves as the senior vice president of pandemic prevention and response at the Rockefeller Foundation. Rick, you are my go-to when these things happen. I first want to ask you about what started at the beginning of COVID, the issue of there were things going around and we were not testing properly. Is our testing regimen ready for Omicron in the United States?
Ali, thanks for having me back. A lot's happened this last week, and there's a lot to catch up on. But, you know, one of the critical components of getting in front of an outbreak such as the SARS-CoV-2, especially with new variants, is our testing capabilities. And as you know, as you mentioned, last year it was dismal. I would give some kudos to the United States. We have, in the U.S., increased our testing and surveillance from about 0.1% or less than 1% to about 10%. However, it's not equally distributed across the country. It's not reaching all pockets of our country that we need to reach. So there's still a lot of blind spots. There's still tests that are unavailable in many places, and the cost of these tests are too expensive. So our government needs to do much more to get testing in the hands of more people at an affordable cost, and we must couple that testing with genomic surveillance so we can track this virus.
Rick, I wonder when we hear the term virus, a variant of concern, whether that's a term that has meaning in the immunology, virology community, may mean less to us. What we have heard from South Africa is that it does appear to be more transmissible and does appear to hit people who have some antibodies already. When it comes to the concerns about Omicron, what are yours?
Well, Ali, we've seen a lot of mutations in this Omicron variant. However, it's important to realize that we have seen most of these mutations before in other variants, and they sort of fizzle out. What's unique about the mutations in Omicron is their combination. So now several of those previous mutations have combined, and those mutations are in sites that could impact where the antibodies bind to. The antibodies are produced from the vaccines or from previous infection. Where they bind to in that virus, and do those mutations make those antibodies bind less well? Therefore, is the virus able to escape? Now, I want to highlight that we expect this to happen. We expect some variation in our immune response from previous infection and from vaccines. But everything we've seen still, Ali, tells us that if you are vaccinated, if you're fully vaccinated, you're going to have some protection, even against Omicron, from being severely ill, hospitalized, and dying. So it's really important to realize the vaccines we have, they may not always prevent you from getting infected, but they can save your life. And it's really important to be vaccinated as soon as possible.
Rick, we have not heard yet, and I don't know whether this is just bad reporting or it's true, we've not heard yet of deaths connected to Omicron reported. Or are we just too early in the reporting to understand this?
We're tracking it really closely. The first thing that we see, Ali, is an increase in cases. And we are blessed that we have an early warning system. Our Pandemic Prevention Institute was supporting the groups in Africa and around the world. That early warning system, Ali, is the only reason right now we are even looking for Omicron in the populations around the world. But what we see with SARS-CoV-2 in the past is that you'll have an early increase in cases. Then you might start seeing an increase in hospitalizations, and they are in Africa, as you've mentioned, in South Africa. And the next indicator we might see is an increase in deaths. So far, what we have seen is that people who are vaccinated are experiencing really mild and moderate illness. So it gives me a lot of confidence that if we're vaccinated, that that's likely the outcome you're going to see even with the Omicron variant, although we need much more data to say that with certainty.
So all of this sounds like, all right, maybe we've got the tools to deal with this, except this business about it spreading amongst children under five in South Africa. Obviously, we do not have the defenses for children under five in place globally.
We don't. And so that, again, is an interesting early data set. We have to look very carefully into that. Clearly, children under five are unvaccinated. We do have data. We're getting data to be able to consider the use of these vaccines that we have in younger children, younger populations. So we need to accelerate getting that data set. I am concerned, as you mentioned, that this virus, this Omicron variant, might be a fast spreader, might be a fast mover, more transmissible. However, I'm still comforted that we know that this is an airborne virus. Therefore, we do have the tools, as you mentioned. The N95 respirators provide great protection against a airborne virus such as this. What we need to do, though, Ali, is take Omicron as a decision point in our response to this pandemic. Are we, as nations, going to invest in systems capable of detecting this variant and these viruses quickly? And we're going to follow that action, that early warning, with action and equity to get vaccines and vaccinations around the world and in the unvaccinated populations in our country? Or are we going to allow this virus to continue to dictate how we live our lives? This is a decision point. Omicron has given opportunity. We should act now.
Rick, thanks as always for making time for us early in the morning. We really need the information and the analysis that people like you have. Dr. Rick Bright is the Senior Vice President of Pandemic Prevention and Response at the Rockefeller Foundation. Still to come, my conversation with Energy Secretary Jennifer Granholm. We discussed the White House's historic investment to fight climate change and the future of clean energy. But before that, inflation, a term with ominous overtones, but why knowing that history may calm some of your fears.
There's an assault on democracy.
Scorching triple-digit heat.
The new space race begins.
That is actually the potential America has always had.
The change.